this tutorial, I will show you how SnapGene can help you view and edit translated features, open reading frames, and whole sequence translations. SnapGene is capable of handling two types of translations, full sequence and feature translations. I will start with an example of a full sequence translation. Within SnapGene, I have a file containing the Saccharomyces sec13 gene with an extra 1 kilobase flanking sequence either side of the gene. To find the sec13 gene within this sequence, I will select the Show Translations button to view the open reading frames. A new track is visible that contains either orange or green arrows. These arrows indicate the open reading frames. Top strand open reading frames are colored orange, and bottom strand open reading frames are colored green. I know the orange open reading frame in the middle is sec13. I can see that there is also another top strand open reading frame to the left, and a bottom strand open reading frame to the right of sec13. I will now switch to the sequence view for a better look at the sequence. You will notice that for open reading frames, there is a separate track that displays the amino acid sequence. To use the three-letter amino acid codes instead of a single-letter amino acid code, I can use the button to the left. Looking at the first top strand open reading frame, you will notice that it does not contain a start codon. As indicated in the message in the yellow bar at the top, SnapGene's default behavior is to allow open reading frames to begin at DNA ends. To change the translation settings, I can select the Translation Options button in the yellow bar, or click on the arrow next to the Show Translations button and select Translation Options. In the new window, I can uncheck the option to require a start codon except at DNA ends. Now, the open reading frame will be forced to start at the first AUG methionine codon, as shown here. Alternatively, you can use the drop-down menu and specify other start codon options. Note, there are other translation settings that you can change in this window, such as the minimum length of the open reading frame. The default is 75 amino acids. I will click the cancel button to stick with the default translation settings for this example. Currently, the Show Translation Options is set to display open reading frames only. However, by clicking the Show Translations button, it is possible to view different reading frames, the top three frames, the bottom three frames, or all six frames altogether. Displaying all of this information at once can be sometimes quite overwhelming. For most purposes, the best way to work with translations in SnapGene is to use the translated features. To demonstrate translated features, I will switch back to the map view. I will then select the middle open reading frame, which corresponds to the sec13 gene, and I will go to Features, Add Translated Feature. I will call this translated feature sec13. SnapGene has already defined this feature as a coding sequence, or CDS, and this means it will be translated. Now I will click OK to return to the map. You can see that a feature has been added as indicated by the purple arrow named sec13. I can now turn off the open reading frames by selecting the Show Translations button. So only the sec13 feature is now visible. And if I switch back to the sequence view, you will see that the amino acid sequence is only displayed above the feature. Sec13 is a simple example to use for working with translations in SnapGene, since it has no introns. But what about genes that contain introns? In another file, I have the sequence for the Saccharomyces SAR1 open reading frame without any flanking sequence. I will firstly create a feature of this entire sequence. To do this, I will select the whole sequence by going to Edit, Select All. As a shortcut, you can press Ctrl and A on your keyboard. Then I will go to Features, Add Feature. I will call this feature SAR1, and I will select the option to translate this feature in sequence view. When I do this, notice SnapGene automatically classifies this sequence as a coding sequence, or CDS. Finally, I will click the OK button. To get a better look at the sequence, I will switch to sequence view. The start codon can be clearly seen at the beginning of the sequence. However, there are a few stop codons placed throughout the gene, as indicated by the asterisks with a red background. And in this scenario, I know it is due to an intron. What I want to do now is to remove the intron from this feature. I know that the intron lies between the bases 29 and 167. So I will go to Edit, select Range, and specify the bases 29 and 167 to select this sequence. To remove this segment from the feature, I will go to Features, Delete Feature Segment. When the Edit Feature window appears, I will click OK to return to the sequence. The dotted line between the feature arrow now indicates the intron. If desired, you can always convert the intron sequence to lowercase by selecting the feature and going to Features, Introns, Convert Introns to Lowercase. And if you want to export the translated sequence, simply select the feature and go to Edit, Copy Amino Acids, and then select to copy either the one letter or three letter sequence. Alternatively, you can use the copy button at the top as a shortcut for this. Then simply paste the sequence into the program of interest. For this next part of the tutorial, I will open a file that contains a plasmid with the mCherry2 sequence that is fused in frame with monomeric Egfp. If I switch to sequence view, I can see the mCherry2 feature lacks a stop codon. I know the two sequences are in frame because the extended translation from the upstream feature, mCherry2, is on the same line as the translation of the downstream feature, monomeric EGFP. The two features are also connected with a dotted line with an arrow. To see what it would look like if these two features were not in frame, I will simply add a base just before the monomeric EGFP feature. Now, the mCherry2 feature runs on past the monomeric EGFP feature as indicated by the dotted line. I will go to Edit, Undo Insert Bases to revert back to the original sequence. In the last part of this tutorial, I will show you how to manually skip over translated segments. For example, this form of EGFP is monomeric because it has an alanine to lysine mutation at position 206. However, in this case, the lysine is at position 207 instead. And this is because monomeric EGFP has an extra valine just after the start codon. I'd like to edit the monomeric EGFP feature so that it follows the conventional numbering of GFP, so this valine will be skipped. To do this, I will select the valine and create a feature segment by going to Features, Create Feature Segment. I will call the new segment 1A to indicate valine 1A. Next, I will select the Feature Translation Options button, and in the new window, I will select to skip segment 2, which is valine 1A. I also want segment 3 to start at position 2, so I will change this to plus 2 instead of plus 3. Now I will return to the sequence view by selecting OK and OK again. I can now see that the numbering skips over valine 1A, and if I scroll down, I can see that the lysine is at position 206, as it should be. And that wraps up this video tutorial. You now understand some of the main capabilities SnapGene has when working with translations. For other SnapGene tutorials, check out the other videos on the SnapGene website.